Well, it's all happening again in Florida, minus the hanging chads of 2000. But with all the drama, including a deadline missed by a matter of minutes, the headline is the U.S. Senate race in Florida is now headed to a hand recount. It is just that close. Rick Scott leading Bill Nelson by 0.15%. The governor's race is outside the margin for a hand recount. That's where we stand after the deadline for the machine recounts passed a few hours ago. But in Broward County, the recount didn't count because they missed the deadline by 2 minutes. CNN's Ryan Nobles is in Tallahassee with the latest. First of all, what are you learning about the next phase of the recount?
Well, Anderson, we've entered a period of time now where these races have really consolidated after that first automatic recount of all the machines, the machine recount. And now we know that the Senate race is within a quarter of a percent, which is pretty small in the context of 8.5 million votes. So what's going to happen now is that all 67 counties will begin a second phase of counting, and they're going to manually recount all the undervotes and the overvotes that took place across the state. This is a pretty exhaustive process, but they have to have it done by Sunday with the goal of determining whether or not we can definitively say who won this election. I should also point out, Anderson, that we were keeping a very close eye on the governor's race as well. That was within a half a percentage point after the count finished on Saturday. That race pretty much stayed as what we expected. The numbers did not change that much at all. So the governor's race, that count is over, and we can safely say that Ron DeSantis will be the next governor of Florida. But it's the Senate race that still hangs in the balance. The numbers have really not changed all that much since the initial count. And so if Bill Nelson has any hope of overcoming Rick Scott in this race, they're going to have to really need some sort of a miracle during this hand recount.
And how is it possible that Broward County missed the deadline by 2 minutes?
It's really a head-scratching, Anderson, and nobody really has a good explanation for exactly what happened. And I do think that for the people of Florida, this is pretty disappointing. It wasn't just Broward County. It was also Palm Beach County that did not make the deadline in time. And also Hillsborough County was also unable to make it through the machine recount. And essentially what this means is that they're going to revert back to the initial numbers from the first count that ended last Sunday. So it's not as if those votes aren't going to count, but they just did not get that exhaustive second run through the machines just to make sure all those numbers matched up. Again, we actually know those numbers from Broward County. They didn't really change all that much. In fact, they were better for Rick Scott when you actually look at the data. But it's really just more about the process and making sure that each one of these voters has their voice completely heard according to the rules. And that just didn't happen here in Florida this time around.
All right, Ryan Nobles, appreciate it. With me now is CNN Chief Legal Analyst Jeffrey Toobin and David Boies, who was lead counsel for Al Gore in the legal battle over the 2000 presidential election. David, you obviously know more than just about anyone when it comes to Florida recount. So besides maybe some unwanted flashbacks you may be going through, what goes through your mind when you look at what's happening there over the last several days?
I think a couple of things. One thing that goes through my mind is that things have actually gotten better. We don't have hanging chads. We don't have disputes about whether something ought to be counted because it was dimpled or not dimpled, or you don't have the sunlight test with holding up the micro, the magnifying glass. You now have optical character recognition ballots that are something that you can look at and determine the voter intent in a manual recount. So one thing is it's gotten better. The second thing is that this is not nearly as close as 2000.
Right.
As opposed to trying to make up 400 or 500 votes, they're talking about making up more than 10,000 votes. And to do that, you're going to have to find that something happened with those machines in terms of not counting all the votes. Now, you'll figure that out with a manual recount. But I think the chances that this vote changes is much less than it was in 2000.
Jeff, you made that point as well, and certainly what we've seen now in the governor's race in Florida backs up what David is saying, that, it was a minuscule, handful of votes difference. What do you make, though, Jeff, of the fact that Broward County and others missed the deadline by 2 minutes?
Well, two things. One is the Florida electoral system is still awful and run by incompetent people with inferior machines. It also has laws that are way too strict. I mean, there is absolutely no reason why 2 minutes should make a difference in whether a more accurate count is reported. So, I mean, there remain problems in the Florida electoral system. But as David said, the system is better than it was 18 years ago. I mean, the punch card system is far worse than the optical scan system that's in place now, but it's still no bargain with what they have.
David, do you have recommendations for changes that could be made to make it even better?
Well, I think for one thing, I think Jeffrey's entirely right. The deadlines are too strict. Some of these counts just can't get done in that time available. I think a second thing is they've got to have working machines. Palm Beach County doesn't have working machines. I actually think that if you take the Supreme Court decision in Bush v. Gore seriously, that presents an equal protection argument. Because one of the things the court said is that you can't have people in one county not having as good a chance of having their votes counted as people in other counties. And that's exactly what happens when you have defective machines in one of the counties like you do in Palm Beach. So I think two things. One is give them realistic amount of time. And second, make sure the machines are working. The optical scanning ballot system is a good ballot system, but the machines have got to work. And I think that's easily correctable with a trivial amount of money.
Jeff, go ahead.
Well, if I could just reiterate a point David made earlier. I mean, the Bush-Gore recount in Florida was a matter of ultimately a little more than 500 votes. The margin here going into the manual recount is more than 12,000 votes. You know, that's a close election from a political perspective, but it is not a close election as recounts go. I mean, the odds that Nelson can make up this in a manual recount strike me as close to zero. I mean, that is, you know, a lot of votes for a recount, and I don't think anyone should be under the impression that this election is on the verge of being overturned.
It's an important point, David.
I think that's right.
You said that unless there's some massive problem with machines, that making up this kind of a deficit is nearly impossible.
I think that's right. That doesn't mean we shouldn't do it, though. I mean, everybody who's ahead always tries to end the game. I mean, people who are ahead at the end of the eighth inning in a baseball game would try to make it an eight-inning baseball game. This is a situation in which the Florida law is absolutely clear. You've got a manual recount if you're within a certain margin. Clearly, we're within that margin. Nobody disputes that. And people ought to let the process work out, not try to change the rules in the middle of the game. Mm. I think the chances that it's going to change are very, very small. I think Jeffrey's 100% right about that. But people ought to let the process play out and not try to truncate it.
David Boies, Jeff Toobin, thank you very much. Appreciate it.